We remember the devastating mud flow that came after Mount St. Helens erupted. Now, a new report from the state's Department of Natural Resources says if a lahar like that happens on Mount Rainier, it could cause $13 billion in damage to property and the economy. Megan Hutton has more.
The 1980 lahar mud flow that came from Mount St. Helens was full of mud and debris and reached speeds of 90 miles an hour. The Puyallup Valley last saw lahar 600 years ago. Today, geologists warn three things could cause a lahar on Mount Rainier: an earthquake, a landslide, or a volcanic eruption.
It would be able to knock bridges down. It could certainly knock houses and buildings off of their foundations. It's a very powerful force.
Dave Norman, the state geologist, says a lahar is more likely on the Puyallup side of Mount Rainier because the rocks are made of clay, making them less stable. With nearly 100,000 people living in the Puyallup Valley, a report from the Department of Natural Resources shows the damages could be costly.
If you look at the buildings plus the contents, the parcel value, the land value, you can get to $13 billion is what that estimate is.
It bases these values on total losses. So that is something that the public needs to pay attention to, that this isn't floodwaters that travel through a community and then recede. This is flowing concrete that flows through a valley and stays there.
Jody Woodcock with Pierce County Emergency Management says the report won't change how they train for disasters, but it will improve their recovery planning.
Those businesses, for example, that are the economic core of Pierce County, how can we start making policy decisions now to have plans in place to assist them or relocate them should a lahar occur?
New interactive maps online allow you to look up your own property to see if it's in the path of a lahar. They show a major lahar could reach the port of Tacoma and wipe out I-5 through Fife. Emergency management sees the report as a good reminder to have an escape plan to higher ground, but don't plan on driving out of the valley.
High ground is an easy hike, to get off the valley floor, and then we have plans to collect people and get them to emergency shelterings.
Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.